Hey, g'day. I'm Bob, the founder here at Salad, and you are a startup founder. You're a developer. You're a man on the street looking to deploy inference at massive scale, whether it's 10, 100, maybe 1,000 GPUs without breaking the budget. That is what we're going to do today on SaladCloud. Soup to nuts. We're going to go from zero to a production deployment of SDXL, something that'll churn out 30, 35,000 images a day. Let's do it. All right. So you've signed up, you've verified your email, you find yourself here needing to create a new organization. This is where you can invite collaborators. Your billing is handled. We'll just call this the test org. Within an organization, you can have projects just to help keep you stay organized. We'll call this project one, and we hit create. Now, if you happen to be that man on the street and you just want to kick the tires, play around with Salad and get going straight away to see what we can do, recipes are for you. These are pre-configured open source models that you can take and deploy straight away. We've got all sorts of different categories, whether it's text to image, transcription, image tagging, you will find it here. Let's go with Llama 7B. There's a little how-to guide. Hit configure and deploy. You need a name for it. So this is the test deployment. You want 10 replicas because you're doing this at scale. You hit deploy, and that's where we get you with billing. But enter your billing information and off you go. You can play around with Salad to your heart's content, get a feel for how it works. However, if you happen to be that developer coming in wanting to deploy SDXL at scale, you've got your own custom container with your own LoRAs or modifications, checkpoints, whatever it might be. You've got that image ready to go and you want to get straight into production deployment. We'll go back into our organization. Container groups are for you. So you're going to set up a new container group. You come in here and you give it a name. So this is the SDXL custom deployment. Like I said, you've got that image source that already exists. You can actually pull from a private repo, a private registry, anyone on this list here. Or for today, I'm just going to pull our SDXL model that's packaged up in SD Next and choose that as our image. Now, with a 3090 Ti, 4090, you can expect about 12 second inference times on SDXL with 30-35 steps. So that's about 5 images per minute. We want to hit 50 images per minute. That's the 30-35,000 images per day. So we'll go for a replica count of 10. We'll need 4 vCPUs to power this. SDXL is pretty hungry on system RAM, so we'll go for 30 gigs of system RAM. And then, like I said, the best bang for your buck is actually going to be down here with the 3090. So the 3090, 10 of those. You can actually then configure some custom settings if you like. There's a bit of observability and logging that you can configure. If you just want a static URL that you can hit and load balance across these 10 nodes, you will enable networking. We've actually got this container configured as kind of a queue and worker type setup, so we don't need networking for this. And there's plenty more information on the docs on how you can make these, you know, customize this deployment with those optional settings. But once we have that basic configuration set up, the image source, the replica count, the hardware configuration, we are ready to hit deploy. But this is where there's another gotcha. If you are coming in and making a custom deployment, you've got to request an increase from our team. This is where we're just going to ask for a little bit of information on who you are, what your company is, what your deployment looks like, and then you'll be green lit to go and make that deployment. I'm not going to show you how the sausage is made. We'll be back in 2 seconds with that that whitelisted account. We're back. And I just hit deploy. And here we are at our SDXL custom container group deployment. We've been whitelisted. Next step here is to hit start. And this is where, if it's the first time Salad's pulling your image, your custom image, it might take a minute just to pull it over and copy it into our repo. Then we hit the start button like I just did. And this is where we get this screen here. This is kind of the overall deployment details of this container group. What we'll see here is those 10 replicas, 0 out of 10 are running. We are in a deploying state. And what we're seeing is that we are now in the process of allocating to different nodes. And there you go, 17 seconds in. Our system in the back end there has found nodes that are compatible with the requirements that you've requested, the hardware you've requested, and we now hit this creating phase. Now, what we find is that the cold start times, if you have a really big container, you can expect up to a minute per gigabyte. And this one here, this is a 17 gig file. So what I'll do is hit the old fast forward button and we'll come back once those first deployments get created. Hey, Javier, how's it going? All right, we're back. And we're now about 14 minutes into the deployment. We can see a couple of those containers are now up and running while we wait on the rest to go and create. And it looks like they've all been allocated. Now they're just creating, sending the and distributing each of those 17 gigabyte containers. But while we're waiting on it, let me just quickly show you billing here. We'll need to add a payment method, but at any point you can go in here and we've got a brand new account and organization here, but you can check on your charges month to date. And this will then culminate in an invoice at the end of the month. You can add team members. And of course, we have our documentation, which you can link to. But let's go back to that project one here. Go back to SDXL. And we'll keep an eye on it for it to be up and running at scale. All right, last fast forward there. Today is now tomorrow. Don't worry, Mom, I got two of these shirts. It's clean. And we are in our container group page where we see all 10 replicas are in a running state. It took the first one about 10 minutes to get online. The stragglers took about 15, 20 minutes, but they're all up and running now. We can go down our list and we can see most of them have been up and running for the 16, 17 hours since we deployed this container group. One exception here, 2 hours. So the behavior of the system, this is a fully managed container service. If one node goes down, what we do is automatically reallocate in the background and spin up another container to make sure that you're always at close to, if not the full container count that's requested. And some of the functionality you've got here in this instances page, you can restart containers on a specific node, very fast cold start time for that. Recreate them or reallocate them to a new node. And then we do have some deployment details here. Of course, I didn't set up any custom behavior for these nodes. So on this one, we're running a kind of a pub sub, a queue and a worker type architecture. And all of this functionality is programmatically available via the API. So you can spin up Salad alongside your existing cloud provider as a worker service for inference. And if you're interested on more of the details around an SDXL deployment like this, or an LLM or transcription or image tagging or really any AI inference model at scale, go and check out our blog. Feel free to send me an email. You'll find my email. It's bob@salad.com. There you go. And we can also help out with larger deployments with our team of solution architects. So thanks for joining me on this walkthrough of Salad. And we're really excited to see what inference loads you guys run at scale on Salad.